This is what I expect will be the final video of the Academy series, although you never know, we might add in some more. You never know what AI technology is going to come out, we'll have to update that video, but for now I thought it would be good to conclude the series and talk a little bit about choosing the right tool. So of course I'm a little bit biased here, I work for Reflect. Reflect is a note-taking app that you're seeing right here and that you've seen for the whole series, and of course, you know, we obviously think it's the best one. I wouldn't be working for the company if I didn't think it was the best tool. But I'm going to try and be objective here and just kind of go through some of the important parts of choosing a note-taking tool, because I think this is a deep rabbit hole that people fall into, and it's really, really hard to get out if you just start going around trying all the different tools and never really sticking with one. So that's where I'm going to start off with for this video. Don't be a tire kicker. And if you've never heard that term before, by a tire kicker, we just mean someone that goes and, you know, you're shopping for an important vehicle and you kick the tire to see if the air pressure is low, when that doesn't matter at all. You could just put the air in. I think that's where the phrase comes from. I'm assuming so. So a lot of people will just try all of the tools and they obsess over the tools and they spend more time selecting a note-taking tool and, you know, actually diving into productivity than they actually do taking notes. So don't be that person. Don't fall into the rabbit hole of constantly switching tools. Be obsessed with note-taking, not the tool. Be a nerd about note-taking, not a nerd about note-taking tools. Because no one wants to be a nerd about tools, right? Like, the tool is just a vehicle that's going to get you to the destination. So again, be obsessed with the destination, be focused on the destination, not the tool. Okay, so first I'm going to have you outline the features that you need. So this part's going to be a little bit different for everyone. So you want to list out all of the features that you need the most, because what you want is a tool that has most of the features that you need and as few as the ones that you don't need as possible. That's because each additional feature that is added to an application clutters it. It makes it slower, it hurts the performance, makes the UI more complex and harder to use, and honestly just kind of hurts the product, unless you're very, very rigorous about which features you add in. And that's why a personal note-taking tool is always going to be just that, a very personal decision. And so we don't try to convince the world that they should be using Reflect. There's a fraction of the world that should be using Reflect. You should be using Reflect if you think that it is the best tool that fits your own brain. And Alex made this tool because he felt that there wasn't one that was currently fitting his brain and helping him to think better. So it's a product made in his vision and his taste. That means that it's not going to be for everyone. If you're someone that demands block-level references in your note-taking app, like Rome Research does, Reflect will not work for you, and we're not going to try to convince you that the tool is for you. So you need to make those decisions, but you need to be conscious about them. Seek out the tool that actually has the features you need. Don't just get swept in by, you know, whatever features a certain tool has decided to add. But keep in mind, too, that you might be missing out on some. So I imagine a lot of people coming into Reflect won't have used our Whisper Voice Transcriber because it's really new and not very many note-taking applications have it. So that's incredible. I'm not saying you shouldn't try new features. I'm just saying be very conscious about what you need and what you want and try to find the tool that matches that vision the best and ignore the rest. So there are some universal traits that you should look for, though. So this is, in my opinion, true for everyone. And in which case, you know, I guess you could disagree. But you'll notice that, for example, I didn't put network note-taking or backlinking in here. That's because that's up to your preference. If you're someone that just wants to use a folder system, that's hard for me to imagine. But if that's your preference, that's your preference. And I can't talk you out of that. So I'm going to include traits here that are universal. So number one, frictionless. Now, already I'm having to put an asterisk on this first one because frictionless is subjective to a certain extent. What might have very little friction for me might have a ton of friction for someone like my parents. So choose the one that has the least friction for you. So it's a little bit subjective there, but the notion of it needing to be frictionless is very, very universal. Do not choose an application that has all the bells and whistles, but makes it really hard to capture your thoughts. Next, you want it to be secure and encrypted. So you're probably noticing, by the way, that I've talked about all of these things before. So you can go back and watch the individual lessons on this if you have forgotten. But secure and encrypted, I sincerely believe that this is important for everyone. You need to not be self-censoring. You need to know that your notes aren't going to get hacked. You need to know that the employees who are running the note-taking app that you're using aren't able to see them. That's all really, really important. Kind of related to frictionless, fast and reliable, these are obviously characteristics of it being frictionless, but I think, ironically, people will forget about speed when they're actually testing different note-taking applications, because it doesn't seem like something obvious to put on your list until you notice it. And you might not even be consciously noticing it. You might start subconsciously not wanting to open up your note-taking app because it's not very fast. Honestly, this is the reason why everyone keeps going back to Apple Notes, and the reason why I still recommend that as a fantastic note-taking application. It's super, super fast, and it's super reliable. And then finally, think about the company. So, I think I must have missed a word here. So think about the company in terms of, you know, leadership and fundraising. I mentioned those things for longevity. Make sure you're not signing on to a company that's going to turn into an Evernote where the whole product is just going to dissolve because they've taken on a bunch of venture-backed funding and have drifted out of personal note-taking. Make sure you match the CEO's vision. Make sure they're going to be around for the long haul. Like, I reflect when people ask this question. We have not raised venture funding, but we have a community round that gives us several years of runway, although we're currently profitable, so we don't even really need to tap into that. You can always export your notes, so should the worst case scenario happen, you'll always be able to take your notes with you. All that good stuff, that all plays into this concept of longevity and making sure that your notes are always going to be there. And then there's just a couple questions you have to ask. I think the main one is just like, are you willing to pay or not? You know, Reflect is a paid note-taking app. If someone messages me and they're angry that it's a paid note-taking app, I'm just like, I'm really sorry. I feel that if you're using something every day, you should probably be worth paying for it. But that's a bit up to my personal opinion, so you can decide that. If you don't want to pay or you can't afford to, I think Apple Notes is such a good free version of a note-taking app. So definitely go with that. There's options that are free if you don't want to pay. And then the last point I want to make is just commit to what you're going to use and then don't look back until you absolutely have to. And what I mean by that is make the decision and then lean into it. If a couple months later you find that you're hating your note-taking and you haven't found any workflows and there's just friction everywhere, then great, switch again. But try and make a real decision to choose whatever note-taking app fits best for you and really commit to it. And then just try it, you know, at least for a few months. Whatever new tool you're going to use is going to have some amount of friction, so expect that. But try and choose the one that actually fits with you best, not what everyone else is using, not what's the flashy new thing. And then you'll find you'll really love your note-taking. So for now, that concludes the Reflect Academy. I hope you find the tool that fits right for you, but I really think all of the concepts that we talked about in this note-taking course are applicable across all the tools. So I'm not here to tell you what to use to take notes. I'm just here to tell you how to take notes, and I hope you learned something along the way.